Hello everyone. So today we're going to make a brioche. It's a kind of sweet bread. It's very nice for breakfast. We're having one every Sunday morning. And then with that dough, you can make lots of different little things. And it's really awesome. So we're going to make it now. Alors, we're going to use our mixer again. So we start with 500 grams of strong flour. 500. There. Then we need 10 grams of salt, just in case. Up there. There. 80 grams of sugar, caster sugar. It's very simple. 80 grams. 25 grams of yeast. Yes. There. And then 250 grams of eggs. So basically, regularly, the eggs are 50 grams each, so 5 eggs. You can crack them in a bowl just to make sure you don't put any shell. Voilà, 5. The hook. Give a little stir already. Or it's gonna fly everywhere into the machine. So it's a quite dry dough right now, but then we add some butter once it's all combined together. It's very dry. Do you think I got the right recipe? Yeah, should be alright. There we go. I should have weighted up the eggs. 250 gram eggs. My eggs probably are quite too small. So I add one. I should have weighed them really. There. So that's gonna form a dough. Quite hard. And while that's spinning, we're gonna cut 250 gram butter. In small dice. Yeah, that's better, you see? So you see the dough is quite firm, right? It's quite firm. So now at this stage, once you have your dough, you're gonna put your butter. 250 grams. You can put a bit more, which is called the mousseline brioche. But 250 is quite, it makes quite soft dough, so it's good enough. There, up. So imagine if you do it by hand, it'd be crazy to mix everything with the butter into this hard dough. Some does, but it takes ages. Much easier. Okay, so we let it spin until it's all combined. It It's gonna become very sticky around the bowl. Right, so now we come back to it. It's quite sticky. It needs much more spinning, but we're gonna just scrape the sides to help the mixing. Ready? And then we have to let it spin again until it is not sticking the bowl anymore. So it's becoming a very smooth and shiny dough. Okay, so now it's nearly there. We're gonna scrape another time, one more time. Become nice and smooth and shiny. Up. There we go. Doesn't stick the bowl anymore. So now we're gonna transfer it into another bowl and let it rise and mature for the flavor. Hop. Voilà. This is our dough, yeah? It's very soft. Gonna put a cloth on it. A tea towel cloth. And leave it on the side, you know, room temperature. Then it's gonna rise a little bit. And once after half hour, I think, it's gonna rise a bit, then we're gonna have to fold it back, fold it back, fold it back, give some turn, and then you can preserve it in the fridge till the next day, and you work with the dough the next day. So I got one ready, and then it'll be ready to shape. Okay, so see, that's the dough I made before. So yeah, I made it yesterday, so it had some turn, and it's been preserved in the fridge, and it's quite hard. So it's just ready to shape, really. I'll take it out. It smells delicious. It smells the butter. It's really nice. So, let's make a little few things, yeah? So, with brioche, we can make lots of different stuff. So basically, I cut it at 60 grams to have an individual brioche. Yeah, 60 is good, it's a good size. There. Then if we do... Okay, if we do four long ones, then we're gonna make four Parisienne, which is a brioche with a little head on top. That's quite funny. So it's quite stiff dough, and it's better to work in a very cold environment because it goes very soft and buttery very quickly with the heat. So we need to be careful. Then we could do some chocolate bun. There. And then with this one, we can make, what do we have? 340, 330, so 110. If we do, we divide it in three. There. So this one, we're gonna make a plait with it. So we're gonna give some turn like making a baguette. It long. Same size, yeah. So it's nice to work the brioche dough without too much flour, because then it's too slippery and you can't work properly with it. So let's make a plait, yeah. Squeezed it. The plait. Then in those ones we can put, dig a little hole. I'm gonna put some little chocolate pearls. Close it. Turn it around and finish to boil it. As I close, here is close. Voilà, that's the chocolate ones. Then with these ones, we can do like little ones, and then once it's proof, we're gonna give a cut to make little teeth, so that will be a plain one. So you give some turn like a baguette, make it flat, turn it, turn it, turn it, turn it. Maybe they're a bit too long, too pointy. Make them a bit shorter. Yeah. Voilà. A bit better. There. And those ones. This one is the funniest. So we do just do a make a bowl with it. Tiny bit of flour, and we're gonna put them in those molds. So they're called the Parisian brioche. You just press some little fat, or you can just butter the mold, but this is very useful. So then, you cut the little ball with your finger like that. So you create a head. Then you spin it around and push it in. So with your finger, you push it inside. Down to the table already, see? And then this one goes into a mold. Chick. Again. Spin it around and push it inside. There. Then those ones, when they're gonna prove, it's gonna go boop, and the little ball is gonna pop out like a little head. They can go in a prover. Okay, so the prove, the brioche has been proved. So we're gonna egg wash it. See the head? He's a poop. That's cool. And we can cut some of those. I need to put the boot pit. I need to put some egg wash into this, you know, to wet my scissors, otherwise it'd be sticky. Because if I do that. I need to wet my scissors blade into egg wash. As I, it doesn't stick too much. You see like that, yeah? Basically, you just go in, and then you cut, and you move it along, a long way. Then this one, you can cut it to make it open for the chocolate to come out. A little bit of nib sugar to decorate it. Here as well. And on that big one. Huh? Ready to bake? It's good as well. It doesn't color too much. Doesn't color too much too quickly, and then it stays soft inside. Okay, so we're gonna check the brioche. It looks like it's ready. Yeah, it's ready. That, yeah. So, but not the big one. I'm gonna put it straight on the rack. Little Parisian, the little sugary one. It's hot. The chocolate, we're gonna leave them a slightly longer because they're still quite pale, you see? It's a bit too pale, so we leave them slightly long, 2 more minutes. So now that smells amazing. And that's the brioche parisienne, yeah? Typical. It's been 2 more minutes for this chocolatey one. It has a better color. But we have to leave the big one a bit longer. So let's see if the big one. Yeah, see, it has nice and golden color. I like it to keep it quite pale. Otherwise, it's too dry. If you give too much color, you know, yeah, if you give too much color, it's a bit dry. So just pale, you see, underneath it's nice and golden. All of those. Oh, it's beautiful. Let's try one, shall we? Mm. I like with the sugar bit. It's so soft, see? So imagine that in the morning, in a hot chocolate or in a coffee, it's beautiful. Ah, that's all.